I want a lawyer. Please, I need a lawyer.
Okay, have a seat.
Bitch, sit down. Be humble. Bitch, sit down.
Make up your mind. Decide to walk with me around the lake tonight. Around the lake tonight, by my side. We'll be right back.
Oh, Jip, Jip, get off my screen. Oh, Jip, Jip. Hello, everybody. I hope you're having a good day. It is Saturday, and I've got time today. I've got free time. I thought, why not? Let's just keep going, shall we? Because there's so much to get into with this Jip Jip and then the saga that is surrounding this case, okay? One thing, you know, is reflecting. I made my way to YouTube through the Chris Watts case. Now, I have followed true crime since as far back as I can remember. Used to watch it on Court TV, and Court TV would, like, have trials all day long. And that was always playing in the background. But when Chris Watts happened, not when the documentary came out, like when Shanann went missing, I wanted to know everything I could. And in my opinion, the Watts case is the first case that we've had where we could actually go on Facebook and look at their life, because Shanann documented a lot of their life on Facebook. So I found my way here through a Facebook group. I was doxxed. I've had all the drama, all the bad stuff happen. So with the Watts case, though, my point is, I didn't realize in 2019 that there was this kind of drama on the internet. And so, I don't know. That drama was really crazy. It's hard to explain. Like I said, I was doxxed. I've had a lot of psychos come after me. And it seems like these cases bring out different things in different people. And I'm bringing that up because of the drama that's going on TikTok. But it comes from the Gypsy Rose stuff. If you are coming over here from TikTok, if you have found me through TikTok, comment in my comment section, because I'm just curious if I am alone here watching this TikTok drama. It has been so entertaining, I'm not gonna lie. There's a whole slew of drama over there. Anyone else watch those paranormal watch? I can't with that. It's very hard for me to get into these spirit boxes. Like, if you're into that, I'm not going to judge you. To each their own. A lot of people like watching those spirit boxes and doing them. I find it to be like a radio on, skip, repeat with a filter over it. And you just get to pick out the words. Hello. Hey, Pop and Sass. Hello to everybody. Hello. Hello. You don't have TikTok? Look, my kids do TikTok, right? They don't do TikTok, but they obviously watch it. And I always didn't give a crap, but there's a lot of true crime on TikTok. A lot. And it's really good. And it's interesting to hear other people's opinions on cases. Like Darlie Routier's little sister has I say little sister, she's a grown woman, but she calls herself that. She has a TikTok. There's just all kinds of things. You know, just expand your horizons sometimes. Yeah. Anyhow, I'm just kind of ramble for a little bit. So there's a lot of drama going on with Fancy over on TikTok, okay? So Fancy has had a falling out of sorts. I mean, I don't know what else you would call it with this woman. Her name is Ryan. And I like the both of them. So I hate to see them having a falling out. But I get it at the same time. Just some people aren't meant to be friends. But yeah, I love Fancy too. And I was, I don't understand why Ryan is continuing to talk about it, because I think she's live right now talking about it again. And from what I saw of Fancy's live today, I didn't really see her doing that. She's saying, she's saying, okay. And then she started reading a book. Now, if I clicked out and missed something, let me know. But Ryan was like, I'm not, I've got these text messages, but I'm not going to read these text messages. And then she starts reading them. She's not showing them, but she's basically reading them. I don't know. I'm not like trying to come for anybody at all, because I like Ryan in her way too. But I wish she would not do that, because I don't think Fancy, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, I don't know Fancy that well. But if you're concerned about her mental health, why are you talking about your private conversations on a TikTok live with over 1,000 people watching and Natasha Cooper in the chat? All the people that just want to hate this woman because they don't like the way she talks to people. I get it. But everything's like, she needs help. She needs help. She needs help. Well, if she needs help, why are you dragging her right now and talking about her private conversations? You're doing the same thing that Natasha does and all these other assholes. Thank you, Sandy, Jersey girl. All right. I just had to get that out. It's getting crazy in the singing. I understand. I understand. But I also don't think anyone has the right to, I mean, look, you want to know another thing about TikTok? I got in my For You page a video, and it was like trigger warning, okay? And it was, I'm just going to be blunt. It was two junkies living out of their car with a one-year-old. And what do? They fucking live stream that shit. They were in a homeless tent with this one-year-old, live streaming it because they're begging for junkie money. I'm just saying. It was triggering. I cannot believe that is going on in our world, in our society, that you can be a junkie with a toddler that you're ignoring because you're doing a TikTok live stream. And this poor baby, oh my God, it blows my mind. But on this channel, it wasn't just videos, and they give you the links to this channel. I just, there are a lot of people with a lot of issues. And I just don't think Fancy's, an issue. I see things like these people doing this. This child doesn't need to be in a tent with two junkies that are e-begging on TikTok. Like, find something else to bitch about. I don't know. If you're worried about someone's mental health, then don't go do two live streams about it. Just my opinion. Not that I'm just some bitch. My opinion doesn't matter. But yeah, that goes on over on TikTok. Like, people, it's just, with their cameras on, they don't mute. Over here, I don't think anybody's really heard my children in the background, because my kids are coming. I can hear them coming, and I'm hitting that mute button as fast as I can. But these people on TikTok, like, they don't do that. It's so strange. And they all are on camera, which is good. Do you. But, like, I don't know. We don't need to see you live stream you ignoring your toddler screaming their poopy diapers. It was so bad. It was so bad. Traumatized. Hey, Punky. Anyhow, that's my rant about the Tiki Talk. I just had to get it out. It's been a lot to watch. It's a lot of rabbit holes to go down with that. We'll talk about that another day. So let's get to old Jip Jip, okay? Because Jip Jip, we're going to go down the rabbit hole. We are going to read this TMZ article that I found, and we're going to talk about the case files where Gypsy was snitching. She got right into prison and started snitching on the inmates. And people that went to prison with her are talking. So we're going to look at some of those TikToks of people that went to prison with her that are speaking out. I was there. Hold on. I was there during Fancy's Live. It's obvious Fancy is super stressed. And I did say something when something happened with one of her mods. And I did say something, but I don't think I was unkind. Right. Like, I'm trying to be as delicate as possible when I'm talking about it, because it's really just none of my business at the end of the day. But I think that, like, Fancy found a little home over on TikTok, and she was, you know, she was having a lot of people that were tuning in. And then Gypsy went up and ripped her 20,000 follower TikTok channel from her. And I, you know, I think she's probably super upset about that. And then this stuff with Ryan. But, you know, what do I know? I'm just some bitch on the internet, okay? I don't know anything. These are all in my opinions for a story. No, I'm joking. I'm writing a book. I'm all for Fancy and she is okay, but her feelings are really hurt. I think so too. And this place can be very unhealthy when you're not in a good place. So I wish Ryan would cut her a little bit of slack and just keep the private stuff private and go your separate ways. You don't have to have a knockdown, drag-out fight about it. Just go your separate ways. Fancy has plenty she can talk about. And Ryan has plenty she can go talk about. So there's no need to make such a public spectacle, because that's what the sharks want. The people in the water that are just, you know, searching for blood, that love chaos, they thrive off of it. They get off to it or something. I don't know. People like to watch other people tear other people down. I'll just leave it at that. So buckle up, get your bags packed and your shit together, because I don't have my shit together. But we're going to go down the rabbit hole. Jip Jip. Oh, Jip Jip. Creepy ass. All right, so let's go ahead and just read this TMZ article. I have not read it yet. If you saw my short video or the stuff I've been posting on my community wall, it is, so Gypsy, okay, some people, I see it in my comment section. Gypsy made a cameo. Cameo is an app that you can go on and pay like D-list celebrities. Like Molly Golightly has a cameo, okay? And a bunch of other people. And you pay them and they'll make a video for you. That's all I really know about it. And Gypsy was going to be charging $100 a video. And some of them are just like a video to tell your family happy birthday. Like, hi, it's me, Gypsy. And I just wanted to tell my mama happy birthday. And the D is fire. Like, that's probably what her videos would be. Some dumb shit. But, and then she was charging $20 a message. So just to have her respond to your message, that's going to cost you $20, okay? But it has already been taken down from Cameo. Apparently, word on the street or word on Reddit is that Gypsy had a violation of their terms of service. So she no longer has a cameo. And she shouldn't, because why? It's like giving OJ a cameo. I wonder if OJ has a cameo. We should look into that. All right. Yeah, that's just ridiculous. $100. Yeah, yeah. But hello. That's all she knows is she's a big con and money, 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 money. And you better be filling her pockets. All right. So this article was posted yesterday and it says Gypsy Rose Blanchard, wave of hate from Nick's supporters. She feels it's unfair. Look at that face. Face only a mama could love, Gypsy. Gypsy Rose Blanchard is getting bombarded with criticism from Nick Godijan supporters. It's been going on since she got out of... Oh, sorry. I was talking like her and it's not her. It's been going on since she got out of prison. But Gypsy feels the haters aren't giving her a fair shake. Sources close to TMZ... I mean, sorry. I can't read today. Sources close to Gypsy Rose tell TMZ she's been inundated with folks expressing negative feelings towards her because she's now free. Whereas Nick's serving a life sentence for murdering her mother, Dee Dee. We're told that the fact of Gypsy's situation is one over which she feels a lot of guilt to this day. Oh, okay. Well, she hasn't shown that whatsoever. All right, here's some screenshots. Don't get me wrong. I love that she's free since all the abuse that she suffered. But isn't it kind of weird how her ex-boyfriend is locked in jail for the rest of his life and she's at her movie premiere? He is a part of her story too. Laughing face. This girl should not be living her best life if the man that did her dirty work has to face prison for the rest of his life. The system failed Nick, who is autistic and fell into Gypsy's master plan. I'ma just say it. She came up with the plan. She asked him to kill for her. And if we are giving her mom the benefit of the doubt with mental illness, Nick deserves the benefit of mental illness, too. That's a good point there. All right. Still, our sources say Gypsy feels it's not right she's being branded a murderer by some of these overzealous Nick fans. So now if you don't align with Gypsy, you're automatically a Nick fan? No, 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 no. I'm not a Nick fan. People are a fan for the justice system doing their job. That's what I'm a fan of. Gypsy. Gypsy. Oh, she's... Sorry, I'm reading the comments. What are y'all saying? Has anyone else noticed that many of the creators on YouTube that support Gypsy make money on MSM? What's MSM? If Gypsy is exposed for who she really is, Lifetime is going to lose money big time. Exactly. They are. Don't listen to the mainstream media. Ross Kahn. Oh, hey. Hey, Ross Kahn and hey, Polyester Jumpers. If they both were serving a life sentence, I don't think anyone would be mad. I just want Nick to have a fair trial, to present all of the evidence, and to have someone accurately represent him and put all of Gypsy's reality, because Gypsy's the one running a narrative here. And now that people are speaking up against her narrative, she doesn't like it. All right, let's keep going. Remember, Nick was the one who stabbed, where am I? And the reason for that is because she didn't actually carry out the act of taking her mother's life. Remember, Nick was the one who stabbed Dee Dee, and Gypsy was convicted of second degree murder, basically, for masterminding the slaying. Why is basically in there? With that in mind, Gypsy also thinks it's strange Nick is getting sympathy from folks who want to see him freed. We're told she believes he enjoyed stabbing her mother 17 times, so the fact he's got a group of backers is sort of ass backwards. No! What is ass backwards? I can't. I fucking can't. Wow. Gypsy also thinks it's strange Nick is getting sympathy from folks who want to see him freed. No one is saying, Gypsy, that he should be free. Nobody's saying he should be walking around in the general public. Oh, this dum-dum. Yes, welcome, welcome, everybody. Thank you for being here. If you're listening on the replay, thank you too. I just can't. Like, what the fuck? She doesn't get it. She just doesn't get it. Why does she get to act like she didn't do anything? We're told she believes he enjoyed stabbing her mother 17 times. So the fact he's... Who said that? When did Nick say... Did it come out of his mouth? And if it did, please correct me. When did he say that he enjoyed it? Did he say that? Yes, she is still twisting it. While making this guy out... To just, I don't know, it's, Gypsy enjoyed because she was laughing in the motel room. I tried to get that video before I went live, the brownies. We're eating brownies. And in a little while, he'll be eating me. Yeah, right after you stab, you were Gypsy. Just because you didn't pick that knife up, and we don't know if you did or not, because we can't get the autopsy report, Gypsy. Nick had fantasies, but he didn't enjoy it. That's what I thought. Let me clean my glasses. He convinced him. Hello. Hello, 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 hello. She's still trying to live out her fantasy life. Yeah, she is. That's for sure. All right. Let's keep going. So the fact he's got a group of backers is sort of ass backwards. Oh, Gypsy. Remember, Nick got life in prison without the possibility of parole after his conviction for first-degree murder. Gypsy got a 10-year sentence, but was released on parole last month after more than 8 years of incarceration. Our sources tell us Gypsy feels like she tried to help Nick in his 2018 trial by testifying. She came up with the plan to kill Dee Dee because it was the only way she could escape her mother's abuse. She feels her testimony was the right thing to do to clear her conscience, and we're told doing so helped her forgive herself. Now we're told Gypsy has no feelings towards Nick. She doesn't want to communicate with him, and she's trying to leave their past behind and move forward with her new life. That must be nice. Our sources say Gypsy doesn't hate Nick, but she doesn't love him or feel sad for him either. Okay. Because you can do something horrible to a person and feel no guilt, Gyp. I think she might be dead inside. Andy. Hello, Mirandy. XOXO. Catherine. I honestly think she's mad still because she didn't get away with it. But if you think about it, some people do 15 years in prison for Mary Jane. Yeah. Yeah, right? Yeah, I think she got off pretty easy. MO33. I love you. I'm sorry. I miss you. Terry Bailey. Oh, sorry. I need to stop reading the chat. Let's finish this fucking article. She just doesn't feel anything for him, good or bad. Yeah, he was so awful to you, Gypsy. Okay. Some of the same folks attacking Gypsy online say Nick should be freed too, but we're told she feels his punishment fits the crime. Our sources say Nick told Gypsy in text messages before Dee Dee's murder. Hold on. Our sources say Nick told Gypsy in text messages before Dee Dee's murder he was going to enjoy killing her mom. And Gypsy feels her ex is a danger to society and needs extreme mental health care while behind bars. Okay, that's what we're saying also, Gypsy. Nobody said he should be let out. Where's your ownership of the text messages and the things that you said in those text messages, ma'am? Let's talk about that. Let's talk about what you said. What you set up. You stole a knife from Wally World. But we know you were on them knees, girl.
Bruises anywhere. I don't want you to show any of your, don't show any of your body parts, okay? How'd you get that?
You made me shave my legs and kneel on the ground and clean up the blood. So I think I got carpet burn.
See, it's carpet burn? From just crawling around on the carpet when you were cleaning up the blood. Okay. Anything else anywhere else?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right.
I want a lawyer. Please, sir. Sir? I want a lawyer. Please, I need a lawyer.
Okay, have a seat.
Bitch, sit down. Me on move. Sit down.
I need a lawyer. Yeah, that's at the very end of her interrogation. Hey, Snake. That's the only time she realizes she's fucked is when the lawyer, I'm gonna have to clip this part too, the interrogator, the detective, he gets up and he's like, I'm not doing this with you anymore, Gypsy. I'm not gonna sit in here and let you lie. I'm done. You're done. You're done. And he walks out the door. And when he walks out the door, it's when she's like, sir, I need a lawyer. Yeah, he did. You see? He's like, you're done. I need to clip that part too. And she sits down and her face just sinks. And she's, you know, in her head, she's like, I'm fucked. What do? I'm fucked. I need a lawyer. No mention of a wheelchair. No mention of a medical abuse. No mention of a Mickey button.
YouTube's name was Mickey Button. And so she came up with a song. It went like this. Mickey Button. M-I-C-K-E-Y-B-O-T-T-O-N. Mickey Button. Mickey Button.
B-O-T-T-O-N, B-O-T-T-O-N, button, 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 Gypsy, button. She spelled it wrong. Shit's funny. Mickey Button, let's do it one more time.
YouTube's name was Mickey Button, and so she came up with a song. It went like this. Mickey Button, M-I-C-K-E-Y-B-O-T-T-O-N, Mickey Button, Mickey Button.
Yes, I know buttons. I'm very aware. I know. M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E. Yeah, I get it. B-O, but she spelled button wrong, okay? Disney needs to copyright that bullshit. Hey, Sin. B-O-T-T-O-N. Button. Button. All right. Let us continue here. Some of the folks attacking Gypsy online say Nick should be freed too, but we're told she feels his punishment fits the crime. Our sources say Nick told Gypsy in text messages before Dee Dee's murder he was going to enjoy killing her mom. And Gypsy feels her ex is a danger to society who needs extreme mental health care while behind bars. Is that it? That's it? That's the article? Riveting, TMZ. Riveting. Good job. Gypsy. Gypsy, why do you keep deleting your freaking social media? Why are you hiding all your videos? I am confused. Why? Bad for the, not a good look, as we would say, not a good look. They named a feeding tube a Mickey Button. Yes, they did. Yes, they did. It's her Mickey Button. Couldn't even come up with her own. B-O-T-T-O-N. Gypsy is a dangerous one. Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay, so we're going to go a little more down the rabbit hole, trying to figure out if I should. Where did I see? Okay, here, I'm just going to read this. It's in my screenshot, so it's a, I got to find it first. Okay, so this was written from someone whose mother was incarcerated in the same prison as Gypsy. And they wrote, "Hey everyone, I'm new to the group. I've been following Gypsy's story from the beginning of the trial. And like many, I pitied her at first. I met Gypsy last spring when visiting my mother-in-law at Chillicothe Correctional Center. Gypsy's job was to take pictures of inmates with their visitors, and she took this picture with us. When she walked in the room, her nose was so high up in the air, she would have survived if the room flooded." I believe that. "Seeing the body language of other inmates in the room spoke volumes. Many of them scoffed and rolled their eyes when she walked in. My mother-in-law had absolutely nothing good to say about her and told me she was a very disliked inmate because of how conceited she was. She was friendly at all. She wasn't friendly at all to me. She didn't wear her dentures, and she wasn't very clean. My sister was super excited when she heard I met Gypsy and asked me if I'd ask my mother-in-law to get her autograph. When my mother-in-law asked for it, Gypsy's exact response was, "Ugh, I'm just so tired of signing autographs all the time." She could not handle the fact that my mother-in-law had an episode on Netflix about her story, and she wasn't the only one with her story aired. I've been nothing but disgusted after from seeing her soak up the spotlight after getting out. Gypsy thinks she's a celebrity and social media is to blame. Glorifying her is something I'll never understand. And this woman, it has been confirmed that her mother-in-law was featured on a Netflix documentary. I can't remember it off the top of my head right now. Okay. So I'm going to play a couple of videos from this other person. Let me find it. That was at the same prison with Gypsy. Let me pull it up. I bet Gypsy stank. When Gypsy was in the interrogation room. Shit, hold on. I lost my train of thought. I imagine Gypsy has no interest in putting on her nice girl act until... Oh, I think... Shit, hold on. Chip's husband. Oh, there's Ash. Hi, Ash. The last time she was nice, she was bamboozling the parole board. Right? I wish they would have filmed that. That would have been interesting to watch.
I just didn't do anything.
Oh. Oh, TikTok sucks. On the computer. Okay, now I have got to see where this begins. What is the date on this?
Millionaires. Have you guys watched Gypsy Rose's new docuseries on Lifetime? I just did.
Wake up with me and... I didn't think I'd be doing this, but here I am doing it. I guess these New Year's Hey, what's up? If I'm Cassandra, and if you didn't know me, now you do. I'm coming to you because I want to tell you guys that I went and rewatched my videos on my ex-fiance that was...
I'm trying to find out when she started talking about Gypsy. So bear with me.
Hey, everyone. So this is my outfit of the day. Everything is Zara. My top...
Hey, what's up, TikTok? I am a psychic... Hey, what's up, TikTok, to all my friends. I know I've been gone for...
All right, so maybe that's where it's at. We're just going to start here.
Listen here. I look at this shit and I'm like, are we for real? Is this what we're doing? Listen, Gypsy Rose. You did less time than I did for drugs. You know what I'm saying? You had all to do with your mom's unaliving, girl.
And you think you call that fair? Not to mention, how the hell did you manipulate the courts and everyone around you to believe you? And the only way that it's coming out is because you can't lie, girl. You get out and you put your face on this camera and you suck at actually telling the truth. Like, we can see through you. You tell on yourself. You're not good. You might be able to manipulate your way through life with some people that ain't got no sense. But girlfriend, I've been to prison. I've been a manipulator. I've been a liar. I know one when I see one. And girl, no one cares about what your outfit of the day is. What I care about is that you're over here getting all this attention and making money off what you did to your mama. At the end of the day, no matter what your mama did to you, you are not God, Miss Thang.
This woman was in prison with Gypsy. Okay, so she knows her a little bit from prison. She'll go into that. She's just, I get what she's saying. Why is this? Look, we have a freaking murderer prancing around the internet, and the younger generation thinks it's cool, okay? And that's what I have another problem with.
And it just is a matter of time. The right person's going to give you attention, and Ryan ain't going to give you enough, and you're going to be back on those pills, and you're going to be running and gunning and living wild. Because you were wild when you came into prison in Vandalia. You still wild. It ain't out of you. Girl, I see your future, and I hope it goes better than I believe it will. At this point, you got to answer for those sins, girl. Forget what I think. Forget what social media thinks. At the end of the day, you know, and so does the higher power. Knows what it is. Forget what I think I know. And I guarantee a limb what it is.
Hey, Amore Bella.
Someone needs to be reminding you, girl. Those DNA changing sins you do stick with you for all of eternity and forever and beyond. You know what I mean? They form you. So you might be wearing the outfit of the day, but one day, girl, may God rest your soul, you know, type. I would definitely be coming clean. And the last thing I would be doing is showing my face all over social media. I'd be getting me right, figuring it out. And until I had it completely figured out, I wouldn't be showing my face anywhere. Because, girl, I have a bad feeling you're going to come out. You've been locked up too long. And if you didn't have freedom prior, you still got wild in you, girl. Not to mention, I think you need some counseling. Major counseling. And some acceptance of what you are. Fill in the blank. Have a good day.
Hey, what's up? I'm Miss Moon. You don't know me, now you do. And check this out. This is about Gypsy Rose. And this is for like 100 of my comments on my videos saying don't talk about her because we're just keeping it alive, making her famous. Blah, blah. Listen, my little old videos on my little not even 4,000 people account, trust me, is not affecting what's already happening about Gypsy Rose.
Hey, ma'am, sir.
And no clout here because at the end of the day, I don't even have no following. But who cares? My point is I'll speak my mind on this app however which way I want. And this is what I feel. I've come to the conclusion. I think Gypsy Rose should take a lie detector test. I would love to get the results and know if she... I want her to take a lie detector test. Let's find out the truth.
Yeah.
And I want it to be by someone that's credible, you know?
someone that actually had.
Well, I mean, George Anthony, Casey Anthony's dad, he took a lie detector test. Oh, yeah, let's throw that out there. Take a lie detector test, Jip Jip. She needs to be wearing a different outfit, prison guard. Yeah, with her high heels, her magic legs. I can walk.
Actually has experience doing it, not just some country old lie detector, whatever. I would love to see her take a lie detector test. Let's find out. Let's find out, Gypsy Rose. I challenge you. Take a lie detector test.
Challenge.
Let me pick the lie detector person. Because, yeah. I challenge Gypsy Rose to take a lie detector test.
I
want to see her friend.
I like her. Someone
study body language. Have like 3 or 4 experts that do this kind of stuff. I challenge that.
Well, I still haven't finished. I have like a Gypsy playlist. Okay. But on the playlist is, there's a YouTube channel. It is called The Behavior Panel. And they did one on Gypsy. I haven't finished watching it yet to see all of their input. But check that out if you haven't yet. They're usually pretty good. So I like her. I want to be her friend. What's her name? Cass Jude. Cass Moon. I think she goes by Miss Moon. Cassandra. Here, I'll put her TikTok in here. Go follow her.
If she didn't do what she said, she didn't do what we all think she did, what most of us think she did, that she had everything else to do with it and that she's manipulated this whole situation. And if you didn't and you're innocent, you'll do it. You would have already put this doubt in our minds to rest. Put it to rest, Gypsy.
Prove me wrong.
Yeah. Please prove me wrong. Take a lie detector test. Be an open book. Really, you want to change, people. You want to bring awareness to whatever syndrome. Put all of our doubts to rest. Take a lie detector test. Prove it. Prove it, girl.
Prove it.
I will publicly apologize, but who cares what I think or say? But at the end of the day, the whole world and all of America, at least, and more probably, all are doubting you. And now we're looking at you like this. Because now that you've got out of prison and we all got to see you do your interviews and talk, we don't believe you no more.
Mm-hmm.
You were the girl prior, before you got out of prison, and we believed that shit until you talked. You started talking and you ruined it.
Prismo.
Most people see through bullshit, Gypsy. Put us to shame and prove your innocence, girl. That's what I'd be doing. That'd be the first thing I'd do.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up? I'm Miss Moon. What you looking at? So what? Yeah, I woke up like this. And I'm rocking it. Out doing some things. You know what I mean? Because this. Let's answer this question. It says, let's go back to why you were in prison. So I don't know if you've watched any of my videos, but if. Look at my. But if you have, if you got on my page and you watched my videos, you would see why I was in prison. But also in that video, I did state that it was for DURGS. And I also stated that I did more time than her altogether. Yes. I never unalived anybody or I never had anything to do with unaliving anybody. It was for DURGS and I did more time than her. Anything else you'd like to know? Thanks. Have a good day. Hey, what's up? I'm Miss Moon. So I'm just going to reply to this. Maybe she was eating up attention because the only attention she had all of her life was from her abusive mother. Just a thought. Very true. Also, there's another comment. I'm just using yours for, it was the first one I could get to. But I've seen some comments saying that she never really got attention and she only got attention from her mother. But
I hate to say that, but that's wrong because she's got so much attention. She got trips to Disney World. She got houses. She's got so much attention that it's sickening if you think about it. Look at all the videos of attention that she was getting. Okay? She got tons of attention for being sick, remember? For being something wrong with her. She got tons of attention. I don't think it was the lack of attention. I think her mom gave her lots of attention. She got tons of attention. I think that it was the reason why she acted like that when she got to prison is because the lack of like social, being socialized with kids her age or her age period, or knowing how to act other than her game, her and her mom's game of fooling people, manipulating people, of acting sick. I think she did that for so long, you know? And I think that she was, I think that she's just an immature period. I think even if she lived this normal kind of life, I think she's just emotionally immature. I think that's just who she would have been, period. I think that it would, she might have been, took her longer to be mature than others. Also, I think that she very much likes the opposite sex attention. So it just wasn't attention, period. It was attention sexually. She was a person that liked to be wanted and flirted and all that. Like, that's what she, that laugh she has, always laughing and playing games. Like, she was in middle school, like middle school, elementary. Like, we're grown-ups, you know? She's, like, running around being chased by some girl boy in prison. You know, I don't know. She definitely just likes attention, period. I definitely took her as a person that didn't tell the truth either. I think she lied about things just to be cool. I mean, we all probably have done that in our...
Hold on. Yes, she was... I read it earlier, if you rewind. There's a... I'll drop the article in here. It's a TMZ article. And, you know, it's Gypsy talking about how everyone supports Nick and he's a murderer and it's unfair to Gypsy. Here's the TMZ article. Oh, that's not it. Ignore that. Wrong one. Okay, and I will be dropping in a little bit a Discord link. I have made a Discord. If you don't know what Discord is, I'll explain that later. But it's basically like a group chat type of a deal. You can have voice chats in there. But it's kind of just a place if people want to talk about it, you know, or just whatever. It's, I'll drop it in here later if anyone's interested. Share links and things like that, videos. No, she has no remorse. She doesn't. Why doesn't she talk about her mom? Like, that was, you are kissing your mother. That picture of Gypsy and her mom kissing at Disney World.
Gypsy's mother locked her in a backyard shed when she learned her daughter.
No, she didn't.
So this is for all the people that said that Gypsy was only tied to a bed. It said she was tied up, supposedly up in a shed. So yes, I'm correct. That's what she said happened. Her mom put her in the shed.
that's okay. True too. If you run one wrong, comments. I know how to run a
Discord. This is the facts. Wasn't a bed, it was a shed.
Gypsy's mother locked her in a backyard shed.
Is there anything you'd like to say before I pronounce sentence?
Maybe a little.
Yes, sir.
When this whole thing happened, like I've said it before, I must say, it's just very much the truth, so I'll just say it again. When this whole thing happened, all I ever really wanted to be is with Blanchard. That's all I ever wanted to be. I've never known what it was like to have a motherly love. I've never known what it's like to have a female connection. I've I've never known any of that. None of it. Because I've never known it, that's part of the reason why I strive so hard to get it. So much to the point where I don't even understand what it even feels like to have a female connection. It's missing. It's a missing link. It's always been a missing link.
That's so sad.
And that's the reason why
I think it's sad.
When I got so deep into this situation where I fell in love so deeply, they do say, and they've always said it, love is blind. They've always said that. Well, I'll admit it, I was blindly in love. That was always very much the case. It was always that way. So I understand that you're a fair judge. I've heard it from both my parents. And all I ask is just for mercy, please.
Is what?
Mercy of any form. That's all I
have. Yeah, that's kind of sad.
You know, people call her the master manipulator. It wasn't that.
Oh, I clicked off of it. Damn it. There it is.
You know, people call her the master manipulator. It wasn't that. It was the other way around in that relationship with her ex. It was the other way around. She was manipulated. You know,
that clip gets me every time. She was manipulated, and then the look on her face after he says that.
Part 3 to my fiance being unalived. Part 4. Part 5.
Oh, it's not a weenie dog. Hey, TikTok. It's got a basset hound. Isn't that what they're called?
But you have had to clap back at some haters. You know, one response, one clap back in particular has just gone viral. But you have had.
You think someone would be telling her what not to say? Her clapback shows how immature she still is. It shows some old behavior, just like her post after her mother schmurder. Wow. Rumor
on the- What's a soul? People are so fucking stupid. I can't take it no more, and there's no drugs that help me. There's no antidepressants that's helping me with this.
Well, I think yelling about it.
Sorry, I'm the Roseanne.
This is my second time.
Okay.
Okay.
If I keep scrolling through TikTok and keep seeing the same old shit about Gypsy Rose Blanchard. Yeah, I get it. I get it. Everybody else is making content. I'm just going to keep on making content about this lady. Considering I was in prison with her and I got a pretty good idea. I've seen her up close and personal of what type of person she is. And it's exactly what I've been saying. A manipulator. So make this make sense. Gypsy manipulates a man online, okay? Has him unalive her mom. Goes to prison. He is doing life, and they won't even give him any kind of recognition for his autism at his appeal, right? The state gave him a check, but now is not going to recognize that he has autism or anything possibly wrong with him. Make that make sense. Gypsy gets out early. He's doing life. Gypsy gets out of prison. She gets a big following for what? Unaliving her mom. Now is a millionaire for unaliving her mom. All this for unaliving her mother and having her mom unalived. Just as much or more in the wrong than Nick. And she's manipulating everybody around her. She's showing the same behaviors that she had prior to unaliving her mom. She's just living her best life. Remember that? Remember? She's clapping back, living her best life, just like she clapped back before she went to prison after she unalived her mom and she put that sick shit on Facebook. Clap back. Go, Gypsy Rose. Live that best life. But don't forget, just because you didn't do the, you say, girl,
all your lies and all your stuff, it's going to catch on up to you. So no one cares about
your net worth
after lockup. Okay.
Hold on. Her net worth is $3 million, Ross Kahn. If you Google it, that's what it says anyhow. Let's Google it right now. Gypsy Rose Blanchard net worth. According to one source, Blanchard's net worth has reached an estimated $3 million. That is from Distractify. I don't even know what the hell that is. But yeah, that's what it says. Yep. I'm living my best life and you can't take that from me. See, I need to get all these clips uploaded to my StreamYard so I can click them. And the D is fire. Oh, cringe. Cringe.
We care about your life when you were at your mom's and what you did. And all your supporters, you know what I think about that? They need help. Y'all need to get your head checked. Your teacher, husband now, but was boyfriend, that reached out to you, a teacher supposed to be a good man in society, teaching our children, this is who we let teach our children, takes it upon himself to write the person that unalived their mom, or had something, did have something, a big part of it. Make that make sense. He needs his head checked. That alone tells you where Ryan's at.
Uh-huh.
I mean, Ryan, I can't see anybody real sane being with Gypsy, period, but
I just can't understand it. Out of all the men, why did she choose Ryan? Because Ken, he wasn't bad looking. But, you know, Ken broke her heart, and then he's the rebound. Ryan is the rebound. I think it was her ticket to Louisiana. She wanted to move to Louisiana, and she didn't want to live with her mom or her dad or her stepmom. So she settled with Ryan. Did y'all see the picture? I put it on my community post. And I don't care if people smoke cigarettes. I vape, whatever. But it's Gypsy and Ryan, and they are both smoking a cigarette. And I don't know why. It's hilarious to me. Like, what are you doing, Gypsy? Stop. You're trying to be edgy. And it's just...
That was truly cringeworthy.
Very cringe.
But dang, America needs their head checked. Ryan needs their head checked. All your supporters need their head checked. Get it together. She played a role, the biggest role in her mom's unaliving. I don't care what she did. She could have done a lot of other things. Funny how people think that she deserved it. No one deserves to, you know, no one should be playing God, because we're not. It's not okay. You knew you had lots of other options. You knew you had all these options with all these other boys and all these other things you'd be doing. Come on, Gypsy, another thing. We know you knew how to walk the whole damn time. The lengths you go for lying and manipulating. And yeah, you are just like your mama. Yeah, I said it. If I keep scrolling through TikTok and keep seeing the same old shit about Gypsy Rose Blanchard.
She had 7 years to learn a lot from some of the best criminals. That's very true. She had a lifetime worth. A lifetime. But yeah, you're right. That's a very good point, Mimster. She chose Ryan because she will know he wouldn't be able... She would know, she will know, he wouldn't be able to get someone, even on Gypsy's level. That's something she will always be able to use against him. She knows he's a simp. He won't leave her. He's a cuck. He's a cuck. Ryan the cuck. If you don't know what a cuck is, Google it. It's absolutely Ryan. Ryan the cuck. Oh. All right, let's play a couple more, and then I'm going to read from the report.
Okay, I have a serious question, but I'm going to roll the clip first, and I'll be back. Please hold.
Louisiana, we're not used to the snow. I'm excited, super excited, super nervous, but in a good nervous.
Okay, Ryan, the sweat rag. What's going on with it? No, but I'm serious. Like the
sweat rag. Yes, sweat rag. I'm sorry, that's fucking funny. Let's see, we can go to her original video.
Okay, I have a serious question, but I'm gonna roll the clip first and I'll be back. Please hold.
Louisiana, we're not used to the snow. I'm excited. Super excited, super nervous, but in a good nervous.
Sweat rag.
Hey, Ryan, the sweat rag. What's going on with it? No, but I'm serious. Like the sweat rag thing. It could be like an underlying issue, no? He said in Louisiana, they ain't used to that snow. So if it's snowing, that means it's kind of cold. Outside. My question yet and still is, how are you sweating in the snow when it's cold outside? And I know people are gonna be like, oh my god, that was the last episode, that's when he was picking up Gypsy, he must have been nervous. Even with nerves,
oh my god,
be sweating in the snow. This is a thing now. Please hold. The couple was spotted at Walmart, and
he's got the sweat rag again.
There go that rag. Ain't no way that D is fired, because
it's a sweat rag. Noticed it until she pointed it out, and now I can't unsee that sweat rag. Oh, that's great. Oof. I will follow you back.
If that D is fire, then that sweat is putting it out every single time. Oh. I guarantee you. Ooh, Gypsy be lying, honey. Gypsy just know how to lie. Oh my goodness. That sweat towel probably just be all moist and just, ooh. Ryan, we gotta get rid of the sweat towel. It's not a look. It's not a look. I guess I get it. I guess it's like easy access, you know, just.
<Mm-mm>. No. No. That was fucking great. Oh, I needed that. That was fucking hilarious. Sweat rag. How do I save it? I don't have my regular TikTok. Her name is Laura Beauty Coach. Follow her just to catch. It was funny. Okay,
I have a serious question, but I'm gonna roll the clip first and I'll be back.
All right, please, where am I? Now I gotta go all the way back. That was great.
As somebody who was able to get 10,000 followers in less than 10 days, the number one thing I can tell you is to interact with videos like this that talk about going viral so that TikTok knows that you want to go viral. Your algorithm.
And the wings.
Okay.
And I just can't remember what airport that was at.
Gypsy Rose throwing Nick under the bus ASAP. Wow.
New Orleans airport.
It's an odd statue to put in an airport.
Yeah, and it always scared me. Like, and I'm like, what is that? It looks like a gargoyle. And Mom's like, it's from a story. It's a piece of art. Once I found out they came from real bodies.
Actual people?
I'm like,
pumping and pumping.
No.
Scared you off.
Not doing it. Oh, no. That is just sick.
How you doing?
Thank you. Good.
I'm Mike. And again, Stan's going to come up and talk to you. All right?
Okay.
How you doing? Do you need anything?
No, sir.
Don't care of it.
See how her voice changes? Her voice changes as soon as that officer comes in and she knows she's about to have to talk to this man. Hi. Yeah, I'm okay. It's all good. I didn't murder my mother. I love my mom.
There's some paperwork of yours here. I'm just going to leave it outside the door so I remember that it's here. Any other bruises anywhere?
Oh, and not
the bruises. Don't show me any of your body parts of it. How'd you get that?
You need to shave my legs and kneel on the ground and clean up the blood. So I think I got carpet burns.
See, it's carpet burn from just crawling around on the carpet when you're cleaning up the blood. Okay. Anything else anywhere else?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right.
Go night, night.
Cover back up that blanket if you want. Hey, Gypsy. Sorry to have to wake you up. Talk to your boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
There's a whole lot of stuff you're leaving out, girl.
Like what?
Well, I'm not going to get into it with you, okay? You're leaving a lot of stuff out that you need to probably tell me. Do you want to talk to me about it? Tell me about it.
Sure, I'll tell you. Okay. I'll tell you.
You planned this with him, okay? You didn't get locked in the bathroom, okay? I'm not stupid. First of all, the lock's on this side, so you can't get locked in there. Okay. You went in there because you brought that knife into the picture. You brought the idea into the picture.
I didn't bring the idea.
You did bring it into. You brought the whole thing into the idea.
No.
He did it for you.
No.
He did. Okay.
I don't think so, Rose.
The lies, they're done. I'm not sitting here all night long.
No, I won't give you. I won't give you any lies. I did not think of this. I know that.
Pedialyte. Yeah, Smokey.
He has a evil side, and he did want to do it.
Okay. I understand that.
He wanted to get rid of my mom.
Yeah,
hold on.
Yeah.
Let me get it. I gotta play it.
The lie detector determined that was a lie.
Oh! Yeah, ma'am, that was a lie. There you go. Throwing Nick right under that bus.
Because you asked him to.
He wanted to.
Yeah, because you asked him to. Plain and simple. Gypsy. We're not playing this game, okay? You asked him to. That's why he did it, okay? Plain and simple. We're not playing this game. I'm not going to spend all my night long listening to your lies anymore. You told me the truth on some things, but you left a lot of stuff out. You left a lot of stuff out. So we're not playing this game, okay? He's already told me everything. Everything. The knife was mailed. You guys mailed it here, okay? We know where the knife's at. So the gig's up. You're done. It's up. You're done. You're done. You hated your mom.
I did not hate my mom. I loved my mom. And he.
You would have never done this to your mom.
He needs to tell you that I honestly have been having horrible, and I didn't want to do it. And he said that he would commit suicide if we didn't. Yeah. Did he tell you that?
Yep.
I said that it was a bad thought that I was thinking, I don't think that we should be doing this.
A lot of people think about stuff, but when you act, that's when you cross the line.
No, Gypsy. No. That again.
The lie detector determined that was a lie.
Oh! Okay, you very much talked him into it. There were times where Nicholas tried to talk you out of it, and you insisted that it was the only way. Okay.
Line, and that's what you've done. You acted upon it, and he acted upon it. So, okay, we're done. You're obviously going to keep telling me lies.
I'm not sure.
You're devious.
Now you're going to be booked in for later on down the line. You're going to be booked in for probably murder. Okay, as long as and with him as well. Okay.
Right. I didn't murder my mom, sir.
listen to me. You did, because you're behind it. You pulled all the strings on it, and you're behind it. So now, listen, Gypsy, I'm going to sit and argue with you about it, okay?
Only when it was so, coming get me.
No, that's not all you wanted. There's a lot more to this whole story that you're leaving out. I'm not going to play the sympathetic game. I'm not like that, okay? I can see right through it, okay?
Please. Yep.
I'm not able to be in jail. I have a lot of medical needs.
I understand that.
Oh, now you do.
I'll get taken care of, okay? So sit tight.
You're done. Oh, there's the lawyer part.
Please, sir? Sir? I want a lawyer. Please, I need a lawyer.
Okay, have a seat.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
Bitch, sit down. Me on move. Sit down.
Down, Jip Jip. Be humble.
He actually stepped out right now, so if you just want to hold that, and when he comes back, he'll be able to, okay?
Baba. I know, right? Me too, Annabelle. Me too. Her secret knock. 3 knocks and 2 scratches. Yes, Susan, I will. I appreciate that.
Let's get straight into it. So a couple things I want to address about Gypsy Rose, and then I'm done talking about her, but let's get into it. So first of all, I don't know if anybody has gone to CaseNet, Missouri CaseNet, and looked up Gypsy Rose and looked at her file. Okay, so if you go to Missouri Casement and you go to put Gypsy Blanchard in the
hold on, I'm gonna skip.
Hey, what's up? I'm Miss Moon, and I am commenting back on a comment that someone left me on my last video. My last video was about Gypsy Rose, of course, and Gypsy Rose Blanchard. And I was talking about how I got on Missouri CaseNet. It is a free website that you can go on and look up people's crimes or what they've been in trouble for. So here we go. I was on the website. I put her name in the search bar. When I put my name in the search bar, it popped up three cases. One, two, three. I went to, I don't know if it's the first one, middle one, or last one, but one of them. But when I clicked on the case, you go to docket entries. When I went to the docket entries, what it's going to do is tell you all about anything that was on the docket in her case, okay? I scrolled, I did a whoop, just a little scroll. When I went down just a little bit, it said plaintiff put in for a name change, okay? It was accepted by Arkansas. Pretty much that Greene County cannot uphold the request because pretty much till she gets off parole, whatever name she had when she caught her case is what it's going to say. Okay. Now, I don't know what this means. I don't know if I assume that it has something to do, like maybe when she filed for her annulment, maybe dude Ryan don't even know this has happened. Maybe this is why she hasn't changed her name to Anderson. Maybe she's not even really married to dude. I don't know. I can come up with 1,000 reasons. I'm just bringing you the truth that is free records. Okay. I don't just sit around and make things up. So I guess I'm going to have to walk you through it, and that's okay. Cause that's what I'm here for. And you know what? I appreciate you. Hope you appreciate me. So here we go. Let's get into it. When you get to
yes. the website,
Missouri.
The chat is fire.
When you see it, you're going to put her name, her last name first no down here. Her first name. You're going to press search. And after you do that, this should pop up. See? There's the three cases, okay? I'm not sure which one it is. I think it might be the last one or the first one. Either way, when you press it, it's going to look like, here you go. This is what it's going to look like. This is what I've seen. I did a little.
Well, I noticed she's just now using Anderson on her secret Facebook account and also on Cameo. Before they took her Cameo down, it was Gypsy Anderson. She probably does that to get away from the Blanchard. You know, because she doesn't identify as a schmurderer. She doesn't identify as that, okay? And she's on her journey.
Well, scroll. You go down to 9/13/2022. What it says is court in receipt of the correspondence from the defendant on 9/13/2022, requesting a name change per defendant order for name change was granted in the state of Arkansas. Court notes that the ruling in other states are jurisdictions have no bearing on Greene County cases. Therefore, no action is taken at this time acting for the case number. Okay. So what it's saying exactly what I said, that it is approved, the name change, for Arkansas and other counties and states. But Greene County, it's staying the same from what it's always been, which would be Blanchard, because they cannot uphold the name change due to what it's saying in between, you know, without actually saying, is that when she caught her case, that is the name that she will be known as, and that's in that county, it is staying Blanchard. Okay. So I don't know if it's like she never actually, she did get, you know, married and then she annulled it. And maybe Ryan don't know. I don't know why it would say Arkansas specifically, because Dan lives in Arkansas. And if I need to bring you those receipts, I will, because I have screenshots of everything, because I case-netted them all, because all of their cases, including Dan, because he's caught cases in Missouri and lived in Springfield too, which Missouri is where I live. And so did Nick Godejean, because they're in Missouri. Okay. You can look, it's public record. Okay. And so I'm just saying, I don't
Dan the meat man.
Just say things to say things. It's real. I also found out Nick Godejean is only 20 minutes from my house where he is incarcerated. Kind of cool. But anyways, all I'm saying is this. I literally have some amazing documents to bring to you in my next video, which is all screenshots of his appeal and some really interesting stuff that I don't think public's seen yet.
Oh, so let's check that out.
Let me tell you how you know.
Where is it? Hey
guys, is my...
Yeah. I'm a... Hey, yep. I'm doing it again.
Huge breaking news, guys.
Toxic families.
Huh.
Hey, I'm Miss Moon. If you didn't know me, now you do. I am going to bring you a story about this girl. Miss Moon! That's me. My dog even got a lot to say about Gypsy Rose. Is that how you feel, boo-boo? You think she unalived her mama? Is that how you feel? Hey, how do you feel?
And so, why is there more?
Miss Moon!
And social workers.
Okay. There's so much... there's so many people talking about this on TikTok. I could play so many videos. Nina Beauty Influencer. I'll play her videos next time. But I was going to read through some of the case file from the Greene County Sheriff's Office. This is in 2015 after their arrest. So let me bring that up. And I've got some pages marked down. Okay. Go to my notes. See what pages. All right. Page 37. All right. This is a supplemental report by Mr. Hancock here, and he's having a phone interview with Megan Pack. And it says, I was contacted by Megan via phone call about some Facebook information which she thought might be important involving Gypsy. Pack stated she was a staff writer for a magazine called Creepy Catalog, which was based out of St. Louis, Missouri. Pack stated she had anonymous sources sending her articles and comments about Gypsy from Facebook. The Facebook picture depicted Gypsy wearing a red and black outfit, holding a knife to her mouth. Oh, you mean this one? Oh, this one is what they're talking about right here. This picture. This one right here. So what? Okay, so this information was obtained by Greene County Sheriff's Office via search warrants from Facebook. Pack stated she would send me updates, but had nothing further to add at this time of this report. Okay. Let's read that again. I'm trying to understand what exactly that is saying. I was contacted by Megan Pack via phone call about some Facebook information which she thought might be important involving Gypsy. Facebook information involving Gypsy. Pack stated she was a staff writer for a magazine called Creepy Catalog, which was based out of St. Louis, Missouri. Pack stated she had anonymous sources sending her articles and comments about Gypsy from Facebook. And then she showed her the Facebook picture. So she was a part of a Facebook group? Is that what that means? Like, why did they have her pictures of her with the knife? Because was she in a group, a Facebook group? Is that what it says? Oh, thank you, Prisma. I appreciate that. All right, let me go to my next page. 46. Page 46. Okay. All right, this is on 7/8 of 2015. Okay. This is a good one. This is the it's a Waukesha County jail phone call Gypsy. So it's a jailhouse phone call that Gypsy had made. I received a DVD of Gypsy Blanchard's phone conversation from Waukesha County Sheriff's Department, Waukesha, Wisconsin, while she was incarcerated in their facility. The DVD was logged into evidence. I reviewed the conversation Gypsy had with her family. When Gypsy would speak to her family, she would call them by their relative relationships, such as aunt, uncle, etc. She told her family she could not talk about what had happened, per her attorney. I heard Gypsy call the female she was talking to Aunt Celeste. And I think Celeste is Rod Blanchard's sister. Why is she calling? Oh, no, that's weird. And it puts the phone number. Gypsy spoke of how she was innocent and she got messed up with someone very awful. Gypsy told Aunt Celeste she wanted to live with her family in Louisiana when she gets released. This is in 2015, by the way. This call was placed on June 21st, 2015. Gypsy placed a phone call to phone number blah, blah, blah on June 22nd, 2015. Gypsy was talking to a female she called Christy. Okay, Christy, as we all know, is Gypsy's stepmother. She told Christy she could not talk about what happened. Gypsy told Christy to tell her dad she was innocent and she wanted to know if her dad still loved her. Gypsy told Christy the things which had been said on the news were not true. Let me read that again. Gypsy told Christy the things which had been said on the news media were not true, but the lie detector, hold on, I gotta get him a little board. I need a mouse, but let's get it.
The lie detector determined that was a lie.
Oh! Yeah, big one. Gypsy told Christy the things that had been said on the news media were not true. They weren't true. Gypsy asked Christy if she got out of jail, could she come live with her? I can just hear that, Mama. I'm gonna get out of here, Christy. And you know, it's I didn't do anything. I love my mom. I love my mama. You know I do. Where did I have that clip of her saying that? Anyways, I'll continue reading here. If she could come live with them when she got out of jail. Gypsy placed a phone call to phone number blah, blah, blah on June 23rd, 2015. Gypsy started talking to Christy and then a male got on the phone who she said, who she called Daddy. And no, it wasn't Nick. Just kidding. It was her actual dad. It wasn't Ryan either. During the investigation, it was discovered Rod Blanchard was Gypsy's biological dad.
Gypsy and her dad talked about what jail was like and if Gypsy knew when she was going to be extradited to Springfield, Missouri. Gypsy's dad told her he cared and loved her, but he was confused and he had a lot of questions. Gypsy would not talk about the case with her dad. Why not? Why not? Gypsy talked about how she wanted to build a relationship with her dad, and she told him she wanted him to know she was innocent. But you were not innocent. Oh my Lord. I wonder, I have a thing. I think that I said it earlier that she picked, one of the reasons that she picked Ryan to marry is because when she gets out, she's on parole and you have to be with a family member. And Rod and Christy had this bedroom all set up for Gypsy to come home and she went and got married. And I think it's because she never wanted to live with them. You know, will you let me live there when I get free? You know, have a place for me. She didn't need that, though. She found another way out. In my opinion, and allegedly. All right, a phone call was placed on phone number blah blah on June 24th, 2015. When the call was reviewed, the female's voice did not sound like Gypsy's voice. It was the voice of an unknown female who was talking to an unknown male. It was the voice of an unknown female who was talking to an unknown male about trying to get bailed out of the Waukesha County Sheriff's Office jail. There was nothing else of evidentiary value on the DVD pertaining to the homicide. All right, let me see what I have on this one. Page 51. All right, page 51. Handwritten statement. This is when Gypsy, this is on 9. Okay, so we're in September 4th of 2015. So she's been in jail, you know, a good bit at this point. Hold on, but why does it say in July? Okay, that's the report time. It's on 9/4, but this says on July 14th. So backtrack on what I just said, I guess. Why would it have two different dates? I don't know. I can't see chat right now, by the way, so I'm not ignoring you. Just give me 1 minute. Handwritten statement from Gypsy from the jail about marijuana found. Report. On July 14th, 2015, I was contacted by Lieutenant Marty whatever about a witness statement Gypsy Blanchard filled out while she was housed in Tower 2 at the Greene County Justice Center. Lieutenant May stated he wanted to give me a copy of the statement. I collected a copy of the statement. And it was put with the case. I read the statement Gypsy wrote to Greene County Sheriff's Office Corrections. The statement said Gypsy observed inmate Amanda Flores using the toilet when she heard what sounded like a plastic bag crunching. She observed Flores put the bag in her vagina. Fachina. When Gypsy asked Flores what was in the bag, Flores did not tell her, and Gypsy observed Flores trade another inmate. All right, Flores did not tell her, and Gypsy observed Flores trade another inmate. Excuse the typos, they're not my fault. Gypsy did not know the name of the other inmate she traded commissary with. What she observed to be marijuana for some commissary. The next day, Gypsy told a corrections officer about what she had observed. So there she's snitching in the prison, snitching, being the old snitch. They were getting the bags of marijuana and putting it in their vagina.
And you're nasty. You're nasty.
Mm-hmm. Good old Sherelle. Bringing out the old clips. All right, let's see what the next page is here. Here's the handwritten statement. By Gypsy. I, Gypsy Rose Blanchard, I saw Flores using the toilet and I heard a crunch bag sound. I saw her put a small bag in her vaginal area and asked, what's that? She said, nothing. Then she pulled the bag out again and traded some weed for commissary to Elba. Then gave some to Rodriguez, a cellmate. Rodriguez took it she cannot spell. And they both I declined. I skipped one. Rodriguez took it and they both ate it, got high. Then they went to sleep. Flores offered and told you, Officer. Offered then some. I declined. The next day I went to walk a something and told you something, Officer Babin. What happened? Something kept quiet, then kept quiet until Monday when a cell check was done. Weed was under her mat, hidden in something paper. Oh, Gypsy. Why are you snitching in the prison? That's not good. You know what they say about snitches. All right, let me see what next page I have. Okay, what is this one? It's 59. Letter from Gypsy to Rachel. What is that? Let's see what that is. On August 3rd, 2015, I was contacted by Greene County Sheriff's Officer Dwight Williams about a letter he had received from Gypsy to be mailed to Rachel and Ray Miller. Rachel and Ray Miller. This is really blurry, so bear with me. Corrections Officer Willis stated he was advised by Greene County Prosecuting Attorney Dan Peterson and have the letter turned over to me and logged into evidence. I obtained the letter from Corrections Officer Willis, signed it, chain of custody. I reviewed the letter and then logged it. The letter was dated July 28, 2015, and contained information about how Gypsy was overwhelmed when she found out Rachel and Ray tried to write her a letter. She talked about how Nicholas was her ex-boyfriend and how the media is making her out to be a monster when, in quotes, my part was small in this. That's a direct quote. My part was small in this. Yet she felt as though she was taking a lot of the blame for the murder. See, she's been doing this from day one. I didn't do anything and Nick did it. And see, I didn't. Nick did it. Nick did it. Mickey Button. Love letters to psychopaths. You have to get JPay, Smokey. Download JPay. I don't ever get on Instagram, but I got on the Instagram and I was like scrolling and then this page came up and it was inmates and they like I guess it's like a video call, but they're like, yeah, hit me up on the JPay. It's disturbing. It's weird. But I don't know. About how she, okay, hold on. Blame for the murder. She asked in the letter, yes. She stated in the letter, yes, I'm in trouble, but a great, oh wait, it's hard to read. Yes, I'm in trouble, and I'm a part of this horrible, tragic act. Gypsy talked to, I just want to make sure I didn't miss anything. Yes, I'm in trouble. I'm a part of this horrible, tragic act. Gypsy talked about how her life with her mother was not what everyone thought it was. She talked about how she was not sick and she was very healthy. She claimed to not remember what had happened because of the medication she was on. Oh, how convenient, Jip Jip. You just happen to be high as a kite and you just don't remember what happened. Yeah. Sure.
The lie detector determined that was a lie. Oh!
Again. Because of the medication. She talked about the relationship she was building with her biological father and about how she would be able to stay with him when she got out of jail. The letter did not contain anything else pertinent to the homicidal case. Well, Jip Jip. My. See. She's probably playing her dad. That's what I feel like here. She's playing her dad. She thinks she's going to get out of jail. She doesn't think she's going to get charged for murder. She's already making arrangements. When I get out of here, everything will be okay. All right. What is this? Mail. I think this is when. Chain of custody for seized property. That's the letter she wrote, which we can read that another time if it's really not too interesting and it's really hard. I had to get someone to transcribe it. It's really hard to read. All right, let me see my notes here. I'm on 59. Okay, 59. This is an interview with Amanda Flores. I received an inmate to staff request from inmate Flores, date of birth, who was incarcerated in the Greene County Justice Center on unrelated charges. Flores stated she had information about the homicide Gypsy was involved in. I made contact with Flores and escorted her to an interview room. The interview was video recorded and logged into evidence. The following is not intended to be a transcript, but a summation of the interview. Flores said she wanted, quote, immunity for telling me what she heard Gypsy say when she was housed in the same cell with her. I told Flores I could not help her out with her case. I could not promise her anything. Flores said she was not a snitch, but she knows a lot about Gypsy's case. Flores said Gypsy was, quote, creepy smart, and she does not want to see Gypsy get away with, quote, it, referring to the murder. Flores continued to tell me she did not want to give up information without being helped in some way. Flores stated before Gypsy came in jail, she supported Gypsy. Flores asked Gypsy if she had, quote, sought Nicholas out, referring to Gypsy seeking Nicholas out to kill her mom. Gypsy told Flores, I probably did. I probably did. Flores began to tell me some things Gypsy had told her about the murder. She mentioned how Nicholas had a cut on his finger from stabbing Claudinia. Flores told me Gypsy told her she cleaned up the blood from the, quote, bed to the bathroom using, quote, carpet cleaner and wipes, which we all know to be true. During my interview with Gypsy, she told me several times she did not go into her mother's room after she was dead. Gypsy told Flores she cleaned up pretty good. Flores said Gypsy would walk about missing her, quote, stuffed animals. She missed her stuffed animals. But Flores could not remember what kind of stuffed animal it was. Gypsy tried to use one of Flores's friends to pass a note to Nicholas. And Flores said she got upset with Gypsy and told her she was not going to use her friends to pass notes. Flores admitted to me Gypsy had told on her for having a misdemeanor about amount of marijuana. So this is the girl that Gypsy snitched on about having weed. So Gypsy snitched and she's getting it back. Even worse. Interesting dynamic there, don't you think? But Flores said this was not the reason she was talking to me. Flores gave me two other inmates' names, Michaela Lutz and Maria Rodriguez, who she said wanted to talk to me. Flores and Gypsy's attorney went to Louisiana to visit Gypsy's family. So their attorneys went to Louisiana. Flores said Gypsy's attorney went to Louisiana to visit Gypsy's family. Flores mentioned how Gypsy had told her on more than one occasion while they were housed in the same cell unit that, quote, I am going to get away with this, referring to the murder. Gypsy told Flores what Nicholas was saying when he stabbed Claudinia. Flores said Gypsy told her Nicholas was saying, quote, you are going to be dead before this happens, while he was stabbing Claudinia. Flores said Gypsy started talking in the cell one night to her, Lutz and Rodriguez, about how she put the knife in Nicholas's hand and told him to go kill her mother. Flores told me Gypsy told her she turned the air conditioner down to 40 degrees to preserve her mom's body, and she cleaned up the blood, including the blood in the bedroom. Flores said Gypsy told her she went into Claudinia's bedroom after she was dead and took $5,000 out of the drawer from a table beside her mom's bed. Flores said the money was in a zipper bag, but earlier she said she didn't go in the room. I think she did. I think that's why Gypsy is, she says when she tells her story, it's always, he wouldn't let me go in the room. I didn't go in the room. I think you went in the room. Flores had nothing further pertinent to the murder. Interesting. All right. Let's see. We may just stop right there. Let's see what page 62 is. I have that marked down. Oh, this is from Michaela Lutz, who was, you know, in the same cell with these girls that were named previously. I made contact with Michaela Lutz, who was incarcerated at the Greene County Justice Center on unrelated charges to Gypsy's case. Lutz told me Gypsy talked about her case when they were housed together on Tower 2 in the Greene County Jail. The following was recorded, and the DVD was logged into evidence. The following is a summation. Lutz said Gypsy told her about how she set the thermostat to 40 degrees to preserve Claudinia's body to keep the smell down, because she knew she was going to be leaving the state. Let's talk, and we know that to be true because Gypsy said that herself. She, when she tells the story, she talked about that. But she had nothing to do with it, and she's not a schmurderer. She's no good. Claudia needs body to keep the smell down because she knew she was going to be leaving the state. Lutz talked about how Nicholas had cut his finger during the stabbing and how Gypsy was hiding in the bathroom while he was committing the murder. She talked about how Gypsy had cleaned up the blood from her mother's bedroom in the bathroom with, quote, carpet cleaner and wipes. Lutz went on to talk about how Nicholas was going to grape Claudinia or Gypsy. She talked about how Nicholas was into incest. Lutz said Gypsy told her she was raped vaginally and anally by Nicholas after the murder. Oh, hold on. Wait a minute.
The lie detector determined that was a lie. Oh!
That's a lie. She has to add that in there every time because it's not true. I mean, you wanted all those things done to you, Gypsy. You said it very clearly in the text messages and all of that. It says right there in the messages what you wanted him to do with you, what your fantasies are. And she wrote plain as day that she was into grape fantasy. That's actually in the supplemental report of evidence that they have not released. The text messages are all there. Those will tell you enough. All right, let's see. Where was I? Hiding in the bathroom, cleaning the blood. Nicholas was into incest. What? Okay, so she went on to talk about how Nicholas was going to grape Claudinia or Gypsy. She talked about how Nicholas was into incest. No, you are, Gypsy. Like, you. No, you. Gypsy, I think that's your thing. I think you're into that. I mean, let's look at the track record here, Jip Jip. I mean, you're like taking baths with your mom. That's weird. You're letting your mom shave your body. That's weird. You were calling Nick daddy and you had that one personality named Kitty. And Kitty was the childlike side of you. Ew, you're nasty. You said you suck out of a baby bottle. Let us not forget that text message. I still suck Pedialyte from a baby bottle. Her words. Is that a little bit of projection there? Just saying. All right, where was I? Sorry. She talked about how Nicholas was into incest. Lutz said Gypsy told her how she was raped vaginally. And oh, we already said that. Lutz said Gypsy was not innocent and she was a sick person. Lutz said Gypsy had gone into her mother's bedroom after she was schmurdered and cleaned up blood from her mom's bed to the bathroom. Did you put that Barney? Was Barney another part of the story there, Gypsy? I'm telling you, she went in that bedroom. She did. She went in that bedroom and got that money out of that safe because she wants to act and say over and over, he wouldn't let me go in the bedroom. I didn't go in the bedroom, over and over, which tells me you're lying because you keep having to convince your own self that you did not go in that bedroom and you did. And did you put this by your mom's head? Hold on, I gotta upload it. The Barney. Oh, Did you put that next to your dying mother's head to comfort her, Gypsy? Because I think you did. What else did you do in that bedroom? Why was there baby powder all over the place? I mean, I understand chafing, but that's extra. Nobody's chafing that much. Just saying. Lutz was told when Nicholas had come into the house, Gypsy and Nick had kissed, and Claudinia was already asleep. Nicholas went over to a chair where there was a box of, quote, spring cleaning items, and picked up a knife. Lutz did not have a description of the knife. The knife was by the box of cleaning supplies, and Nicholas picked up the knife and then, quote, took off. Lutz said they mailed the knife to another state, but she could not remember what state it was they mailed it to. Okay, but you wrote it on the envelope. But knew it was where Nicholas had lived. Gypsy took $5,000 from a nightstand in Claudinia's bedroom. Lutz said there was $10,000 in the nightstand originally. However, Claudinia had put some money down for a new vehicle. It should be noted, a contract between Claudinia and Central Bank of the Ozarks was located for the purchase of a 2011 Nissan Cube on April 9th, 2015. The contract indicated $5,000 in cash was put down towards the purchase of the Nissan. Gypsy told Lutz, after the murder, she and Nicholas called a cab to pick them up, and they went to North Glenstone, somewhere to a hotel. They rented a room for the night, and the next day they went to the Greyhound bus station in Springfield to leave the state, but they could not get a ticket for the both of them. So they went back to the hotel and stayed another night. Gypsy told several of the female inmates on Tower 2 about how Lutz was strong-arming her for phone time. Gypsy told several of the females inmates on Tower 2, I'm sorry, about how Lutz was strong-arming her for phone time. Lutz said she never used Gypsy's phone time and denied the allegations. Gypsy told Lutz if she and Nicholas would have had a baby girl together, Nicholas wanted to have sex with their daughter because he was into incest. Gypsy, what the fuck? Gypsy had cried about Nicholas, but she never cried about her mother's death. Lutz said inmate Amanda Flores had told her Gypsy talked about how she had planned different ways to kill her mother. Some of the ways she planned to kill her mother was by strangling, rape, poisoning, and stabbing. Lutz said Gypsy told her she had paid for everything, the bus ticket, the hotel room for both nights, and the cab fees. Lutz filled out a statement, and the statement was put with the case. Lutz had nothing further. Well, Gypsy, you were singing like a canary when you first got in there. Sounds like maybe a little bit, I mean, with your lies. But I think there's a little bit of truth in these statements from these inmates. I think you had a lot more to do with we'll get to the bottom of it. We're going to keep going. This rabbit hole is not over, not by any means. People are watching Gypsy's every move, and I'm not joking. They are. People are watching. So, ball's in her court right now, I guess. Anyhow, I've burned myself out. I'm tired. I've got to go get some stuff and things all squared away. But I thank everybody for being here. Hey, Batty. Yes. Oh, everybody's waiting. Everybody. Let's see if there's any updates before I end. You never know. Oh. What is this? Hold on, wait a minute. Nope, that's the same one. And nothing new yet. Give it a couple hours. Old Gyp will pop up again. Rear her ugly head. Oh, good night, Terry Bailey. 11:30 p.m. You must be across the pond or somewhere. Good night. I talked about that last time. Allegedly. I don't know if that's such a good... It makes me nervous. How is he going to go live and who is he going to be talking to? Yes.
YouTube's name was Nicky Butt. And so she came up with a song. It went like this. Mickey Button, MickeyButton. Mickey Button, Mickey Button.
Okay. Everybody have a great rest of your weekend. What? I don't know who you are, MC. Front of your normie friends. I don't know what that means. I see everybody. Hello, everybody. And I appreciate everybody for being here. It means more to me than you know. Just that people want to come in here and talk and discuss and, you know, do other stuff and things. Anyhow, thank you for being here. I appreciate you all again. And until next time, you guys have a great one. I'm out of here. Peace out. Bye, guys.
A disclaimer that I don't have all that much time today. Got a little bit of time today.
This beat is going to drop in 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fair game, right?
Bye, everybody!